Here's a question every data scientist faces at least once in an interview. Can you explain precision, recall, and F1 score, and when you'd use each? Now, most candidates recite formulas, but the best ones make it sound human, so let's do that. Precision is about trust. It tells you, of all the times your model said something is positive, how often was it actually right? In simple terms, it's the model's accuracy when it says yes. So when false alarms are costly, like in spam filters or criminal conviction models, you want high precision. You only want to predict positive when you're really sure. Recall is about completeness. It tells you, of all the true positive cases that exist, how many did your model actually catch? When missing a positive case is expensive, say in cancer detection or fraud detection, you prioritize recall. You'd rather over-alert than miss something important. Now, here's where F1 score comes in. Precision and recall often pull in opposite directions. When you try to increase one, the other tends to drop. The F1 score acts as the peacekeeper, balancing both into one number. It's especially useful when your dataset is imbalanced. For instance, only 2% of transactions are fraudulent, but you still need a fair way to measure performance. So, when you're answering this in an interview, you can say, "Precision tells me how reliable my positive predictions are. Recall tells me how many actual positives I caught." F1 score balances the two, giving me a single measure of overall model performance. It's short, natural, and it instantly signals that you understand not just the math, but the meaning behind it. Now, once you've defined these metrics, interviewers often push further. They'll ask, "So how do you handle the trade-off between precision and recall?" Here's where your explanation can really stand out. Precision and recall have an inverse relationship. When you try to improve one, the other often suffers. This happens because your confidence threshold changes. How sure the model needs to be before saying positive. If you favor precision, you set a high confidence threshold. You'll only predict positive when you're very certain. Fewer false alarms, but you'll miss some real cases. This makes sense for applications like email spam detection, where marking a real email as spam is worse than missing one spam message. If you favor recall, you lower the threshold. The model says positive more liberally. You'll catch nearly every true case, but you'll also trigger more false alarms. That's ideal for something like disease screening or fraud detection, where missing even one true case can be costly. And when you need a balance, you rely on the F1 score. It helps you find that sweet spot, where both metrics perform reasonably well. Here's a great way to summarize it in an interview. If the cost of missing a positive is high, I'll favor recall. If false alarms hurt the business more, I'll favor precision. But when both matter, I'll optimize for F1 score.